Molkalia and his other companions or his soldiers. So we know that they are very good at it. So one point I want to make before you take it to the others. Yeah, they are adept at it. And one point I want to make is that the Pakistanis will continue to use this. And let's remember that in the previous two crises between India and Pakistan in 1999 and during Operation Parakram, there was an absence of one of the most destructive tools that is now available to mankind and to you know, organized syndicates like the Pakistani army, the social media platform.
Absolutely. So we have to and they're using careful. This. I think they're getting to your minds, viewers. That, and I want to ask Ashutosh and others. Ashutosh, look, don't get influenced by all of this. Don't push for dialogue because you think Pakistan, because of its fakery, is getting the upper hand. They're injecting negativity into the discourse, saying Modi has failed the public, etc. Why are you getting swayed, Ashutosh? Why are you getting swayed?
See, Rahul, first of all, I fully agree with you that Pakistan indulges into fakery, and today they did indulge. And they tried to have a propaganda warfare. And if they had influenced somebody, I do not know who are these people. But you know, international diplomacy, the two things which should always be remembered. One, the diplomacy should be done from the position of strength and to achieve your targets. Now India is in a position of strength. It has successfully exposed Pakistan. It has successfully destroyed the terrorist hideout and killed more than 350 terrorists. And still, it is Pakistan which has been haunted by the different international communities. So if, and second point is, let's not forget that our brave soldier, Wing Commander Abhinandan, has been caught by them. He has been extremely brave, very dignified, very, very brave soldier. I must salute him. The way he has conducted himself, he has not surrendered, come what may, despite being the custody of the enemy. So when the Pakistan is thoroughly exposed and international community is condemning Pakistan, then from this position of strength, I think there's nothing wrong if India engages in a kind of a dialogue, conditional dialogue, where it puts a pressure.
Nothing wrong in dialogue now.
We want Jaisha Muhammad. Yeah, yeah, just let me complete, Rahul. Three things should be said. One, Jaisha Muhammad chief, Laskar-e-Tayyaba chief should be handed over to India, point number one.
The
point number two,
Pakistan
should promise that their soil will never ever be used
khayenge,
by terror.
Ek saath,
and if it is used for
Hafiz
terror,
Saeed
then
denge,
it will meet
and then they will also
eye.
Hand over gift wrapped with a little ribbon, pink ribbon maybe, the other chap that you have mentioned, Hafiz Saeed. Of course, Jeevan Narasimha Rao, tell me. The service chiefs have just ended their meeting with the Prime Minister. It went up for 1.5 hours. I'm sure they are not sitting there talking about eating pakoras and tea tomorrow in Islamabad with any of these crooked generals and that puppet Imran Khan.
Rahul, if you have followed the entire narrative that Pakistan has been trying to create since yesterday, one, apart from spreading a lot of fakery, indulging in fake news and propaganda, they are also crying for international assistance, international help. Pakistan is clearly cornered. I've been listening to many of their conversations on their own channels. For a change, I think the entire language of Pakistan clearly tells you that they are cornered. They are not in a position to even escalate the war. This was more of a face saver. They wanted to convince their own domestic constituency by indulging in some kind of adventurism. So certainly, I think when we ventured into Pakistan, we certainly, and then when they accepted that such a strike took place right inside Pakistani territory, I think we were certainly prepared for some kind of a counteraction from Pakistan. But our action was against a terror target, and they were trying to target our military bases. And that is where Pakistan loses the entire narrative.
Well, Sushant Sareen, this argument about strength, and I want to bring in Maruf Raza also onto this. You know, this business, oh, now we are in a position of strength, so let's talk to Pakistan, you see. Why are we so scared and reluctant? What is holding us back? This lobby back of, you know, softies from basically stepping on the neck of the serpent and extracting every concession on earth. Sushant Sareen.
Rahul, we would rather surrender than talk to the Pakistanis. Yes. I think it is very clear to enter into a dialogue of the deaf at this point in time would be the greatest folly for India to indulge in. Number one, really, what have we achieved so far? I think, please try to understand the strategic imperative right now. What we did yesterday was to breach a very major red line. That red line was that Pakistan had a concept of deterrence. They used to waive the nuclear threat, and they thought that they can continue to export terrorism into India merrily with impunity, and there would be no pushback from the Indian side. We removed that concept of deterrence yesterday. What the Pakistanis did today was to try and re-establish that red line. As of now, it's a very tenuous kind of a situation. It is very fragile. But the initiative still rests in our hand. If we are now going to start de-escalating or go onto a talks table because the DIM has said, please come and talk to us, or because, you know, a certain small setback which we've had today and a brave pilot is in Pakistani custody, that shakes our resolve, Sushant, because some of these, turn the other cheek liberals want to make some points. Let me just complete my point, please. Please let me complete my point.
Okay.
So the point is that to turn the other cheek at this point in time, this kind of a nonsense which is being propagated right now is only going to turn back the clock to what it was before yesterday. So clearly, we cannot afford to back down. Because if we back down, please remember, the Pakistani impression will be that, look, the Indians tried something, we showed them,
yeah,
they backed down,
precisely.
And we can continue what we were doing. And trust me, the General kind
Mehta,
of terrorism they've been exporting to us is going to go up manifold.
He will get bragging rights. He will say, look, we got one of their guys. We knocked out three of their aircrafts. We did this. We did that. They would do that, you know.
Look, we told the international community.
No, are you scared, sir, of taking this? Are you scared?
It's not a matter.
What is the issue?
We have told
what is the compulsion that holds back General Mehta, a man who served the forces?
You are not letting me speak.
Okay, please. Yeah, go ahead.
If you let me speak.
Of course, please.
Then I'll tell you what. See, we entered into this conflict by telling the international community through the foreign secretary that we are taking preemptive non-military action in self-defense based on actionable intelligence that Jaish-e-Mohammed were going to attack us, more suicide attacks. And so we carried out these preemptive strikes, and that objective has been achieved.
No, sir. We were targeting terrorists. Did they do today morning? They came across. 1 minute, sir. Please let me finish. And they tried to target our military installations. Our military installations, on whose behalf? The Jaish-e-Mohammed's behalf?
No, that's not the point.
Why is Pakistan with Jaish-e-Mohammed?
Rahul?
No, you need to answer this question. I've heard this, sir. I've heard this argument. Several people through the day. We must now speak.
Are
Pakistanis so depraved that they want to stand by the
Rahul,
side
can I please come in?
Yes, General Bakshi, come in. No, sir, please. This business of saying we've achieved our ends. No, we haven't. Pakistan has responded today defending the interests of three misbegotten mullahs.
So what are we going to do?
Mullahs.
What is our option then?
They are the...
Who?
They are the detritus of humanity. And they are fighting their war.
Your option
And they are sending their jets across. They picked up our boy. They've kidnapped our boy for whom? For Masood Azhar?
But what's your
scoundrel?
What?
Who calls himself a Maulana?
Rahul, you
come on, sir, please. What General Bakshi. What option I want to have bring in got? General Bakshi. I'm, sir, quite what tired have you of this.
If what General Mehta will got? Kindly permit somebody else, can I request you, sir? Sir, we heard you.
Go ahead, sir.
Rahul, when you start a conflict, when a conflict starts, you have to define your end state. What was the point of that counter-terror strike on the Jaish-e-Mohammed camp at Balakot? It was to inflict, was it just to take revenge for Pulwama? I'm sorry. What I would like to remind the people of this country is, since 1980, by the war of 1,000 cuts, we have taken 80,000 civilians and military personnel, Indians, killed. I know they are not in the Zulu category, but does that mean their lives are worth nothing? Are we going to try and put an end to it? If we have to, sir, then we have to go much bigger. We have to raise and costs and consequences to a level at which Pakistan is compelled to back off.
Can I ask you a question?
Is compelled to back off.
GD,
if you let off now, 2 months down, there will be more strikes.
What is it?
40 more Indians will die.
What is it that you can do now?
Start
what is it? What more can you do now?
We can do halabalaksa.
Tell me.
We can do one halabalaksa.
Don't shout.
I think we leave it. To why the do people you have to shout? Who are now carrying the responsibility.
Arre, GD,
you and I have had Adesa.
Don't
you
shout.
You and I have had Adesa.
Arre, show
let the boys who are in charge.
Why are
would
you shouting?
Like to swallow
what
Pakistan?
Can we do? Maru Braza, what more can we do? Why don't you lay out the options here? Maru Braza, perhaps the finest tactical
the
mind around has been unspooling the options for the last 4 or 5 days.
Going higher up the escalation
absolutely.
Ladder.
Absolutely. How do we go up you the escalation down, ladder?
May
let's
I,
bring
may
in Maru Braza.
Your name internationally will be in the mud.
Sir, I've heard may this I? Argument 1999. Hostages, and we gave up so much.
Country, sir.
And nothing would have happened. The
Rahul,
Taliban would have melted
finish?
Away into the
Rahul,
dark.
Can I
but we gave
finish?
In.
Rahul, can I please
yes.
finish?
Go ahead, sir.
May I?
Rahul, I'd like to tell you that we did not start this. You know, we attacked the terrorist camps because international law gives us the right to hot pursuit. Pakistan has showed that it considers the Jaish-e-Mohammed as a part of its army. Today, it has struck 3 army locations and they are feeling thrilled, Rahul. They are feeling thrilled
absolutely.
That they got a MiG today.
Yeah.
Rahul, this happens in war. Let them not smile for too long. Let them not smile for too long. There were many occasions at the start of the 71 war where they were getting bouts of euphoria and triumphalism.
Sir, 91,000 of their prisoners were with us.
Thrilled, I say to you.
We handed him back.
I say to you, this is the beginning.
We handed
you
them back.
You started it. We will end it.
Let
you
me bring
provoked
it.
Us. You have
let
pushed
me bring
us.
It.
In 1971,
yes.
you attacked our airfields.
Yes.
You attacked our airfields.
We punished
you
them.
Started it. We finished it. We will finish it today. Don't get too
Maru
complacent.
Braza.
Don't get too euphoric, Pakistanis. Don't get too euphoric.
If General Bakshi calms down, then I can speak.
Maru Braza,
right?
Go ahead. General
battles
Bakshi, let him speak.
Don't end the way they start.
Okay.
Don't
let
get euphoric.
Let him speak, sir.
You will have to pay
General
a
Bakshi,
heavy
sir.
Price. You ask for it.
Oh God.
You will okay. get it.
General
Rahul,
Bakshi, General Bakshi, let Maruf speak. Yes, okay, go ahead. Yes, Maruf.
Rahul?
Yeah.
I think you should have a one-on-one special show with General Bakshi to heighten up national mood. Sir, I have great respect for you, but please calm down. And I also have great respect for General Mehta, but let's be a little more objective. We know there is a lot of fire in the bellies of a lot of people who've worn the uniform. But let's get a little more objective. And I would like to bring out, Rahul, a few points. The first is that I think we started it, and we started it this time, not the entire 30-year-old war on terrorism, but the fact is that we have crossed the strategic threshold.
we have kept the window open for us to act. The window is not closed, and if this nation aspires for greatness, we should be willing to lose lives to achieve a bigger purpose. Jan Bakshi has rightly brought out 80,000 or more Indians have died, and there is time now to take stock of it and turn the corner. This is a strategic watershed. The second thing is, I don't think we should let, as Nitin brought out, I don't think we should let social media dictate national policy.
Exactly.
Because a lot of people on social media, I know they're going to dislike what I'm going to say, but they just pass on and forward messages and they are not entirely informed about the big picture. So let the government, which has taken this big step, after due consideration, decide the next set of steps. And there are steps that you can take without getting engaged only in a tit-for-tat battle. The bigger picture is to get Pakistan squeezed in economically and give Pakistan a choice publicly that you have $7 billion. Now you either survive for 7 days on those $7 billion or you take on India in a conflict over 7 days.
Absolutely.
And then go for broke after that, because you will be completely famished. The third and important point is, please understand, artificial states that are created, like the Soviet Union, they normally last 70, 75 years and they survive on the threat of aggression which keeps their people together. Therefore, the doctored news and doctored information propaganda campaign has been the hallmark of Pakistan, not now, but from the days of its creation.
Yes.
And equally important is also to understand that we have many other tools without getting into a shooting match on a one-on-one basis. I'll give you two examples. Militarily, we haven't even talked about the naval blockade of Pakistan. And that is, without firing a shot, you will squeeze Pakistan like never before. The other option is that you make an open announcement to the world and to Pakistan that should you want to scale it up, as Lal Bahadur Shastri did in 1965, that Pakistan fights on predictable patterns. They want to continue, as was rightly brought out, to operate with a subconventional war with a nuclear threshold.
Yes.
We should be willing to say that militarily, we are prepared to punch you right across the border.
There you go.
And you know it, you can't take it. The Cold Start Doctrine gives them shivers. And those who talk about peace, believe me, we had the strongest tool in our hand in the Shimla Accord with 93,000 prisoners of war.
Absolutely.
And we squandered it because we did not take into account the collective wisdom of this country. The MEA is short-staffed. Don't expect them to fight your battle all over the world and fight it from Delhi also. Respond. Do you know we have a smaller foreign
one
service
second.
Than Singapore?
Rahul, I know, sir.
And we want to be a great
Rahul, no, 1 minute, gentlemen.
And we are allergic.
Rahul,
we
one
are
second.
Allergic to external input.
I think Maruf has laid
there
out the cards.
In this country.
And I think we owe it to our government, we owe it to our forces more than anyone else to today strengthen their resolve rather than weaken it. And I want to bring in Shabnam Lone. 1 second, General Saab. 1 second. I want to bring in Shabnam Lone. She's been listening to this conversation. And I want to ask her, why are you not part of the solution? Strengthen the resolve of our forces. Why have you become part of those who are spreading disinformation, Shabnam Lone? Tell me, suggesting that this is a weak enterprise. We're on a weak wicket. Why?
What?
Why? Tell me. Tell me.
No. You're absolutely wrong, Rahul. It's a matter of record. Last week, I was on every other channel. I'm no soothsayer.
Do you want dialogue?
But this is what I had specifically said.
Do you want dialogue?
That war is no option. It's no, listen to me. That war is no option. But time has come that the Honorable Prime Minister would have to summon his three service chiefs and say that the dark clouds of war are hovering over the nation. Be ready. I never knew that the moment was so near. The service chiefs are with the Honorable Prime Minister just now. Let me state this equivocally. Kashmir war has walked silently and stealthily into Kashmir. And when I hear all the learned panelists, all the learned people talking about so many options, I wonder why they have not understood that war has already walked into Kashmir. So when a nation wings its way for the stability and security of its citizens, I would say that's the most honorable thing to do. If you say dialogue, yes, it's a favored option. But
favored,
I'm stating this, that dialogue now is a failed option. I feel that dialogue will not work.
There you go.
And there is one thing Rahul, which all of you have missed. What is very important is Rahul, the OIC, which has invited Sushma Swaraj Sahiba to its meeting. Now that is a very important step in my way of thinking, because when she goes there, Pakistan says we won't go, and OIC has at many times at the behest of Pakistan invited many separatists.
Well,
so that is a very
Shabnam
important
Lone,
forum. That
Shabnam
is a very important
I am very glad that you are part today
but I'm still saying
of those
that ultimately
who want to strengthen the resolve of our forces.
That
and I want to tell you, war came to war
option.
Came to Kashmir
ultimately,
in 47. It came on.
Way.
No, it came within months of partition. It came
shambles.
Within months of Kashmir when India was
in
formed.
Shambles. It is a latent.
So don't say it has come to Pakistan. It came to Pakistan. It came to Kashmir. Seven decades back, you have to accept this reality. Now, 1 minute. I want to bring in, 1 second. General, I'm going to come out to you in 30 seconds. I want to bring in General. Yes, tell me, General. General Mehta, why are you sticking to your guns?
It's not a matter of sticking.
Of course you are.
It's not.
In fact, you've surrendered your guns.
No, I haven't. I've taken part in all the wars. And so I know what is a war. The question is, your foreign minister in China is making a public statement to the Russians and to the Chinese, telling them that this particular operation that we have launched is against terrorism.
Yes, so why has Pakistan responded?
Yeah, so we are.
So you need to explain that.
Yeah,
what mental psychosis exists in Pakistan that forces them to side with terror? I'm asking you.
In your statement, you won't let me speak. What's the use? If you are going to counter speak, how will I be able to speak?
Okay, sir. Tell me.
But we are constantly telling the world that these attacks are not against the Pakistan military. These attacks are against terrorists. So how do you make a distinction? You can call Jaish-e Mohammed the private army of the ISI, but you're telling the international community one thing. You have
no,
done
we're not,
the same
sir.
Thing.
We're not. Maybe you've confused issues here. General Bakshi wants
issue.
To respond, and I want to open this out to Nitin Gokhale and Ashutosh and Sushant Sareen right after. Yes, General.
Can I please?
General Bakshi, go ahead.
Rahul, it was a privilege to be the instructor of Maruf in the Indian Military Academy. I'm very glad he has grown, come a long way, and I have gotten a reproof. That doesn't matter. Now, I'd like to concentrate very rationally. If we go up the escalation ladder, which we now have no option, because this is hardly the place to get off the escalation ladder. This is hardly the end state you had in mind when you started. All right. You have very little option but to go up this escalation ladder. Whatever be the outcome of the military conflict, Rahul, one thing will be sure. Pakistan's economy is in such a precarious condition with $7 billion in their forex kitty, which is 2 months' import bill. One certain outcome is the Pakistani economy will go down the tube. As to apropos the fiction that the Pakistani army is not responsible, it is the non-state actors. This was a fiction generated by a bunch of peaceniks to prevent India from taking any counter action.
Okay.
It is the Pakistani army, the deep state, which is directly behind the Jaish-e-Mohammed.
Yes.
And if you had any doubt, they have just told you that we consider an attack on the Jaish-e-Mohammed as an attack on the Pakistan army.
That's precisely the point.
They have retaliated by hitting your army.
So Ashutosh,
they are feeling on top of the world today.
Absolutely.
Rahul,
because so they Ashutosh, got one big. Ashutosh, the Karachi Stock Exchange.
Like this.
Yes.
Of course they have, sir.
That an attack on Jaish-e-Mohammed is an attack on the Pakistan army.
They have done it, sir, today. They've crossed the LOC. Why were they crossing the LOC?
Who
you tell me.
Who crossed the LOC?
The Pakistanis.
Naturally, they kept brought their aircraft.
So for why? For what purpose? To hit Indian terror camps? Do we have terror camps, sir? Do we have terror camps? Please, sir. Stop this, sir. I don't know. I don't know, sir. This track to business has messed up people's minds in this country. It's funded. And there's a problem there. Karachi Stock Exchange. I want to go across. 1 minute.
Ashutosh.
1 minute, sir. Ashutosh. Karachi Stock Exchange down today by 1800 points at one time. It went up and rebounded by 200 points to 1600, then closed once again at the lowest possible ebb. They are bleeding. We've opened a window for ourselves, and we are going to speak, sir, according to you, to a state that goes to war for terrorists. Explain this.
Rahul, I can understand that general is very agitated. But war is not fought with anger. War is always fought with cold-bloodedness. Will well-calculated, long-drawn policies.
Please don't teach me how to fight wars. Have you fought
a surprise element?
No. Have you fought a war?
I'm very intrigued.
Have you fought a war? My straight question to you. Have you fought a war? Don't teach me how to fight. I spent more than half my career on the battlefield. All right, Mr. Ashutosh, anything else you can teach me? Don't teach me how to fight unless you have fought yourself.
Don't teach me because there are far too many teachers around today.
Not being allowed to speak.
How war is fought?
Let's not give sermons.
You want to teach me how to fight?
Ashutosh, let's not give sermons tonight. Let's not tell General Bakshi. Don't pick on him. He's a military man. He's been in uniform, sir. Let's respect him. Let's respect him for the sacrifices he also has made.
Let me complete.
Please don't give sermons on how wars are fought. You are the last person from whom I will take
General Saab.
I will still accept it from Maruf because he's a soldier. But you are the last person, sir, who will teach me how to fight.
General Saab should not be shouting at anybody. No, that's not the way, General Saab. General Saab, please.
I will shout at those.
General Saab, please calm down.
I will take it from General Mehta.
General Saab, don't shout. General Saab,
Ashutosh, make your point. Make your point, sir. Explain why should we be speaking to Pakistan that stands with terrorists, that defends terrorists, that fights for terrorists?
I'm not in a mood to smile.
Okay, General Saab, let them go.
You smile, all right? I'm not in a mood to smile.
General Saab, calm down.
Our army boys have been hit. One of our biggest down. And there are some twerps celebrating across the border. I just want to tell them we know how to fight.
We are equally perturbed, General Saab.
General Bakshi, don't take it personally now. These people are going to try and wind you up, so don't take it personally now. Now, just 1 minute, sir, please.
Don't shout, General Saab.
Let's listen to him. Ashutoshji, get ahead. Make your point.
Rahul. In all the panelists, the most important player is the BJP spokesperson. And I think he should explain whether the country, as a party, does he want a dialogue with the Pakistan or war? Has Government of India shut all the doors for dialogue? I think BJP spokesperson should explain that. Because that's the most important thing.
Well, sir, I was hoping you would rationalize why you stand with dialogue in the first place with a country that fakes the news. Number two, that is going to war and any lens to defend terrorists. Anyhow, you don't want to answer that question, it's fine. I'll ask the BJP. I'll ask the BJP, sir. Dialogue is an option or not an option?
Rahul, what has changed? I think this is a decision that the establishment will take. But let me respond as a spokesperson for my party. What has changed from before for us to have a dialogue today? Except a goody-goody statement coming from Imran Khan, who is himself a prisoner of the army establishment in Pakistan. What has changed? We have not been having a dialogue with them because we said talks and terror cannot go together. Has the terror stopped? Have they taken any concrete action against terror? We have really expected them to deliver all this while. They have not delivered. Let him deliver something tomorrow morning. Let him say it's not the same situation that existed a year ago, 2 years ago, 2 months ago. And then there can be a dialogue.
I'll tell you.
But you cannot simply expect a goody-goody statement coming from a Pakistani prime minister who is cornered.
I can tell you.
Whose country is isolated internationally.
Really dialogue, they should come and apologize for kidnapping one of our pilots.
Why are you wanting to bail him out?
They can even begin.
No, Rahul. Rahul, BJP should explain. Is dialogue an option or not? That's a question I'm asking.
They've said it's not an option, sir. They are answering you in black and white. But you are not asking Pakistan why it sides with terrorists. Why is Pakistan ready to go out there and why is Pakistan going out there kidnapping our pilot? No, I'm asking the question. No, 1 second. You see, it's easy today to keep asking the BJP. But it's very difficult to inquire and interrogate your own selves because you are deluded, sir. You should ask your question. What kind of dialogue can we have with a country that is ready to go to war and escalate a crisis? Do you know they were trying to strike our military installations today? For whom? For Mulana? What Mulana? No. Mulana's men of peace.
See.
That Masood Azhar?
Can I answer?
Other misbegotten?
Can I answer?
That other misbegotten Saeed? Hafiz Saeed, who has bled us?
Rahul,
they are going to war for that kind of people? At least, sir, we are fighting a righteous battle. We are doing it in defense of our country and our people. Who are they fighting for? Apostates. They are fighting for terrorists. They are doing it by kidnapping our people. And I want us to look at that. Let's put out this. If Pakistan today is serious about wanting to bridge ties with India, they should free our pilot with an apology. They paraded him against the Geneva Conventions.
No.
They paraded him. Viewers.
And that boy was bleeding.
I don't want to
say
these things.
We know what they did to Saurabh Kalia. No.
You know what they've done? Have you seen the videos? You want to talk to brutes?
No.
Sushant Sareen, I want you to explain to our viewers today how Pakistan has violated the Geneva Conventions. Article 13, Article 8, Article 7. Tell us, Sushant Sareen.
Rahul, there are a couple of things I think we need to make it very clear. We should not have misconceptions. For example, I'll just come to your question in a bit.
Yeah.
We have made an assumption that the Pakistanis are bankrupt, they can't fight. Okay, they have made an assumption that India is too rich and it has too much to lose, they can't fight. I think we need to disabuse the Pakistanis of those notions, number one. Number two, all these characters who are advocating a dialogue, this is the standard operating procedure of these fellows. But all these guys, I want to know from them, you start a dialogue with Imran Khan tomorrow, who is a lackey of the Pakistan army, and there is another attack tomorrow. What are you going to do? What are your options? Will you again walk out of the dialogue? What you need today is not a dialogue. What you need is a 360 kind of a warfare, if you will. And the kinetics of that operation are only one part of it. What is happening yesterday and today and what might happen over the next couple of days is a small part of it. There is an entire thing. Are you willing to say that we will use our economic heft and walk out of the Cricket World Cup if Pakistan is part of it? We don't care a damn. ICC can go and
go to hell for all we care. Can we say that? Do we have that gumption in us to say that? Are we willing to accept those costs? If we are not willing to accept any cost, then we should simply go back home and go off to sleep and let the Pakistanis do what they are doing.
Absolutely.
Which is what people like Ashutosh and others of his ilk want to do. Okay? This dialogue business has been done to death. When have we not gone in for a dialogue? When have we not gone out of our way to accommodate Pakistan?
Precisely.
When have we not shown enormous patience? And yet, time after time, time after time, it's the same thing which repeats itself. Are we now again going to fall for that same nonsense? So look, the choice is before us. Whether we go in for a kinetic operation or not is a very small part of what we have to do.
This broadcast.
We have to have a complete 360 kind of an approach on Pakistan.
In my hand, Shivshankar, look at this paper.
His government, when he was a lackey of the Aam Aadmi Party, when we took a decision against that fellow, that Gawaiya, Ghulam Ali, these guys went out of the way to call him out here.
Absolutely.
They went against the national will at that point of time. Is he now going to tell us what we have to do?
I am suspecting.
These kind of fellows are responsible
suspecting
for
motive,
breaking
but
the consensus
this,
and
in my hand, viewers,
this nation.
Is a Gulf News copy. Now, Gulf News, this is a publication that is published in countries that really don't have much regard for human rights. Even there, Gulf News, what does Gulf News says? Why Gulf News will not release the pilot video? Even they have regard for one person's human rights. Pakistan paraded our pilot today, who I am not going to name, and I'm not going to show those pictures. I want Pakistan to today show those pictures, name him, and bring those facts out. They paraded him in complete violation of Geneva Conventions. It is unethical, it violates the Geneva Convention, and we have the responsibility to guard against any possible war propaganda. This is Gulf News, viewers. And we want us, there are people here who want you to
we cannot have a dialogue
butchers.
With barbarians.
Absolutely. You Rahul, can't have a dialogue with Rahul, butchers and barbarians. Shut it down. I leave it at that. The news are coming up.